I have been learning C++ programming by myself for almost 10 years. In this time, I managed to go from making games in the console to making full 3D game engines in C++, even though people told me that I was wasting my time. And now, I'm close to releasing my first Steam game. So, let me tell you my story, show you my craziest projects, tell you how I overcame the negative feedback got from people, and also, give you some valuable tips if you want to achieve similar achievements. My story starts when I was roughly 14 years old, when my cousin, that was older than me, told me about this thing called programming. She gave me this tutorial and I totally loved it, and this is why I also recommend it in this video. You see, I have always enjoyed building mechanisms and programming was just another way for me to do that. I have to mention that I was very lucky to start so early, but I'll talk about that at the end of the video. Now in the beginning, I just made console stuff. And at some point, I even managed to figure out how to make a 5 Nights at Freddy's clone in the console all by myself that looked roughly like this, and I was pretty proud of that. The thing is that I wanted to learn the cool C++ stuff, like what are all these things that pop up when code block starts. The scripting lines of C++ code told me that there are much more things to learn than just algorithms. I could have gotten some private lessons from a high school teacher, but after looking at what I learned in high school years, I figured out that I already know all of the language stuff that is taught, so I was very disappointed. I didn't know algorithms, but I didn't seem to need them for making my projects, so I just continued on my quest to learn as much as possible about C++. Fast forward some years, while reading from this book I got really hyped to make my first game, and it didn't even seem difficult. I just needed to configure a graphics library. It was. I spent days trying to link SFML or other libraries and even gave up at some point, until finally I managed to make it working and made this little jump clone. Then, I slowly started working at a Terraria clone that turned out very nice, and even got me to a national contest where I met this guy Luca. I have to quickly mention that while we were all computer nerds there, we still messed around and had fun during the contest. Now, Luca was on another level. He was able to make a programming language at that time, so while I am also able to do that now, at that time I was more than impressed. I have to mention that he alone was the best influence that I had, and he helped me get to the level that I am today. If you didn't find a friend like this yet, maybe join my Discord server. Here you can ask me and our community things directly. Then I really started to gain speed. I started learning CD programming and participated to that context next year and even got the second prize. Then made my first Minecraft clone. I also made two other Minecraft clones after. Yeah. I explained in this video why I have 3 Minecraft clones. I also participated to various game jams. These are some games made there and yes, they are still made without an engine. I talk about this in this video, but I don't like using engines because I don't think that you learn much. Plus, I like making things myself. Also, don't get demotivated when people tell you that it is a waste of time. I'll talk about this at the end of the video, but at some point in time, I was told that big game companies use already made game engines, so I'm wasting my time learning OpenGL. Well, tell me this at least. Who will maintain Unity in the future? So now we get close to the present, and you can find most of my projects that I made on my YouTube channel, starting with these multiplayer games that were actually quite difficult to make, but I did them in the end. So now I'm at the level where I can make my own game engine, and I actually have some pretty sick 3D graphics. Finally, I'm also working at a Steam game, so I can become an indie game developer, so if you like my content, do wishlist me right there on Steam to help me. What are the takeaways to take from this video? Well, at some point in time, I started to lose some motivation because people kept telling me that I should learn new technologies and stuff. Game development in companies is also not always well paid. But luckily, I stick to it because I hated doing stuff using already made frameworks, like how web is made. And this is useful because now I have the knowledge that allows me to create anything from scratch if I need to. Now it is faster to use a pre-existing framework, but anyone can learn to do that. So there is this quote that I like, and it is that success comes exponentially. This means that if you spend 1 year learning C++, 1 year learning JavaScript, and 1 year learning Haskell, you'll get to level 1 C++, level 1 JavaScript, and lose all your knowledge after learning Haskell. Okay, just kidding, you don't lose all your knowledge by learning Haskell, but LMAO, bro, can even be procedural. Now, imagine you spend 3 years learning C++. Well, you'd be able to make so much more difficult stuff, and you would actually go to level 5 instead of level 3. Now, imagine spending 10 years of learning only with the thing that you like. You will get in the top, and there, you are well paid no matter what you do. So this is why you should find your passion early and start working at it to become better than others. So, 10 years of learning almost only C++ aren't over yet actually. There are more like 8 or 9, but time passes by quickly and I can't wait to see what I will make this year because I have many great things planned. So if you are interested in also finding out, subscribe and also don't forget that I have many videos where I try to give you my knowledge as fast as possible, so check them out. I hope I inspired you, and feel free to write and link in the description your current most complex project, because I am curious where are other people in this journey. And yes, I reply to my comments, especially the Among Us ones. See you!